And I can't take any more, 'cause the tickets and the taxes and the fees. I work hard for my baby, and they take it away. They don't care, I got a family to feed. They cut my shifts in the mail. Stop using a Zoom Instead Photography, the master set. Let me tell you why you should use a Zoom Instead Photography and when and how you can get excellent results by using a Zoom lens in Instead Photography. Hi there and welcome to my channel. My name is Tudor Matescu and I want to talk now why you should use a Zoom in Instead Photography when and how you can master a zoom lens. So if you are in content like this, please subscribe now to my channel for more content relevant to you. So let's get to the subject. Of course, I started Instead Photography with Fujifilm X100, a fixed lens camera. And that camera helped me a lot. But after that, I've bought my Olympus OMD EM10 Mark II camera. This is Mark IV. Check my review about why I bought Olympus EM10 Mark IV, link in the card. And with that camera I've used a zoom and I've got bad results. I've bought after that Lumix GX9 with a small zoom, and also I wasn't satisfied with what I've got on the street. But not just with that, but with the fact that my mind was burning, thinking what to do, what to shot, and how I can master and use that zoom. And reading about street photography, I've discovered that the masters and all the photography teachers were recommending not to use a zoom, always use a prime lens. And as we all know, Henri Cartier-Bresson used just one prime lens, a 50mm prime lens, to shoot his photography. And in India, a 35mm prime lens, by the way. So after getting informed, I decided, okay, I will start with prime lenses. And I've used for a long time a 40mm equivalent lens, 20mm f1.7 from Lumix Pancake lens. Extraordinary Pancake lens with extraordinary results on GX9. Check my video why you should use a 40mm lens for your street photography. So I got good results with the 40mm lens, but I wasn't satisfied on the streets with just 40mm equivalent field of view, because I was seeing all kinds of shots and I was studying all kinds of street photography styles like soul lighter, and I wasn't satisfied with just one prime lens. So I bought another prime lenses, a 50mm lens, a 45mm lens, 90mm lens equivalent on a full frame. So I've got good shots with these prime lenses. But again, when I was walking on the street, I was feeling some frustration, because sometimes I was seeing good scenes for a 40mm lens, good pictures for a 90mm lens, good pictures for a 28mm lens, and so on. But having just one prime lens on my camera, I wasn't able to do that. And I've tried to use two bodies, and this is good, but it is cumbersome. You don't want to do that all day long. For some time it worked well using two bodies with different prime lenses, and it is a way to do street photography and a good way of doing it. Maybe I will talk about that in another video. But after having some experience with prime lenses, I've decided why not try to use zooms, because now I feel I can have the will, the knowledge and the experience to keep my zoom at the right focal length. And I've discovered that yes, after acquiring this experience with prime lenses, I was able to use a zoom at different focal lenses and keep that zoom at those focal lenses. And I want to share how you can achieve this skill and how you can apply it in your photography. So let's talk about this. So my advice, if you start photography now, it's yes, go with primes. A prime lens will help you not to burn your head, not to burn your mind when you are using a zoom lens. Yes, someone who is just starting photography and buys a zoom will zoom in and zoom out at different focal lenses, not knowing what he's doing to his own photography. So it's very important to not start photography with a zoom. Indeed, not just because you'll get bad pictures, but because you don't know what you are doing and you will burn your head with all kinds of ideas. I should take this picture or this angle or this angle. So you'll zoom in and zoom out, zoom in and zoom out, using in a very wrong way the zoom lens. So you must learn how to use a zoom lens. But to learn how to use a zoom lens, my advice is learn to use a prime lens. Learn to see a prime lens and to zoom with your feet so you can understand what a prime lens does for your photography. So, understanding and knowing a prime lens, in my opinion, it will take you at least 3 months of using it, but using it daily. Not take this lens, for example, use it 1 week on a single day and so on. No, try to use it very, very often for at least 3-4 months so you can really feel it, so you can really see what a focal lens will do to your photography and how this applies to your own style. So, start with the prime lens, understand the prime lenses. After you've understand the prime lenses, I think you'll have the will, the education to master a zoom. A zoom must be mastered. And I feel now that a zoom can't be mastered if you don't have the education in using prime lenses. Because when you use the zoom, you will think, okay, now I'm at 28mm lens. So this zoom will act as a 28mm lens. So you'll know what to do. You will see a shot. You will think, okay, this shot is for a 50mm lens. Let me put the zoom in the 50mm mode and go there and take the shot. Let's say you'll see a close-up shot and you will want to do a close-up portrait like a 28mm. You will zoom out from 50mm to 28mm and so on. So you'll be able to see all kinds of shots in different focal lenses and you'll be able to master your zoom because you will know what are the effects of a focal lens on your photography. So another tip for mastering the zoom, it's from my point of view, keep the zoom at 28mm or 35mm field of view, the general wide all-purpose lens, and depending on the scenes that you are seeing, zoom out at 24mm if you have that on your zoom, or zoom in at 50mm, 90mm and so on. And by the way, this is why I really like this zoom from Olympus, because from 12 to 18mm or Micro Four Self 24 to 35mm lens, this zoom doesn't zoom at all. So they really synced very, very well at this zoom to feel like a prime lens on the most common focal lenses, 24 to 35. At 25, so 50mm field of view on a full frame, it's zooming very, very little. So a nice well-built zoom. I will talk about this zoom maybe in another video, so please subscribe to my channel for this. But depending on your system, choose a zoom that will help you to get that. And by the way, I want to talk what are the focal lenses of a zoom that I recommend for street photography. So the focal lenses that I recommend to have on a zoom for street photography are the 24 to 90mm field of view. I feel that these fields of view will offer you all that you need to do all kinds of street photography styles that you are liking to do. I like to do all kinds of street photography styles and I like to see all kinds of interesting things on a scene because I'm not traveling, and having this ability to change focal lenses and to interpret your city in all kinds of different ways just by changing focal lenses, it is something. So this is my preferred range in a zoom. But of course you can use a standard zoom 18 to 55 on an APS-C body. But I feel there is some compromise and I'll talk about all kinds of zoom on Fujifilm and on Micro Four Thirds in my next video. So please subscribe to my channel because I will publish a video what are the best zooms in street photography in Fujifilm and also in a Micro Four Thirds system. So please subscribe now to my channel to see when I will publish that video. So my conclusions are the following. Start with prime lenses, understand the prime lenses. Educate yourself to see pictures in a prime focal lens. Understand that angle. If you will understand that, you will use very, very good a zoom and you will get very, very well composed pictures. And more than that, you will not feel your head burning by thinking, should I zoom in or should I zoom out, take that scene or take the other scene. No, you'll have the education that you've took from your prime lenses and you'll be able to take that education, to take that discipline that a prime lens gave to you and put it to work in a zoom lens. So, yes, don't start with a zoom lens, but train in photography to get to the zoom lens, because a zoom lens can really help you a lot in street photography if you like doing all kinds of street photography styles, of course. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Hit that like button, leave me a comment, and talk to you soon. Bye bye.